Okay, so I think I found the best mouse for music production that you can buy right now. I've tried cheap mouses, I've tried different mouses. As far as like it being a necessary thing to make music, it's not necessary. But as far as like having a quality mouse, it feels so much better when you're making music with the premium mouse. What's poppin', gang? If you want more videos on music production, subscribe to the channel. So normally when I make beats, I have to have a mouse because, you know, it's clicking in certain things. You know, it's just hard to do on a trackpad and stuff like that when using a laptop. So you gotta have a mouse when you're doing complex hi-hats, clicking in notes and stuff, MIDI notes. It's possible to make beats on cheap mouse and cheap equipment, but it's certain things that you don't get on cheaper mouses. In my personal opinion, I feel like the Razer Viper Ultimate is the best mouse for making music, and I'm gonna tell you why. So before I was using this mouse, I was using the Razer Viper Wireless, and it served me great. It was a great mouse. I had it actually for years, but the mouse actually pretty much like died. Sometimes when I click on it, it has multiple clicks and stuff, like more than one click. And that's due to it being a mechanical button as far as like the clicks. And I guess there's a certain time or point where the mouse has to shut off so you don't get more than one click, because with mechanical clicks and stuff like that in mouses, there's a vibrating pin that makes it vibrate and it can get you more than one click and kind of mess things up when you're, especially when you're making music. So every time I clicked one time on this mouse, it gave me multiple clicks. You know, I had this for years, so it's probably just dead. But so I had to get a new mouse for making music, and you know, I had a cheap mouse like from Walmart. It was like I think like $5, $10, I don't even know. I've tried making beats with this mouse. It was pretty cheap. It works, you know what I'm saying? I got this from Walmart. It just does not feel the same as this mouse. My Mumba stopped working, so I had to switch to a different mouse. And I was using this, and it's just, the quality is super cheap. It's almost like jumping into a Mercedes and then getting into a Honda. So I reached out, spent a couple pennies, and got the Razer Viper Ultimate. This mouse, compared to the other ones, This is kind of like a Lamborghini Huracan as far as all the mouses that's out there. It has a really nice design. It has 8 programmable buttons, and you can use that for your music program, FL Studio, Cubase, Logic, Ableton, and I'm gonna show you how to set it up. When you're looking to buy this mouse, they have different options. You can get it with a charging dock. I thought that was pretty cool, but I didn't get the charging dock. I didn't want to spend over $100. So it came with the mouse itself, the wireless dongle, a charging cord, and the cord is pretty thick too as well. It's actually thicker than the cord that came with my Mumba Wireless. Honestly, it feels pretty great. This mouse has 70 hours of battery life. So far, you know, you don't really have to charge it every single day. It has options on there on the program to shut it off after a certain amount of time. I got mine set to shut off around a minute or two. And it comes with this adapter too, where you don't have to use more than one port, like having one port for your dongle and another port for the charging cable. They give you an adapter where you can just plug your charging cable into one port and the adapter into the charging cable and your wireless dongle into the adapter. So I'm only using one port, which is really great. I'm a huge Razer fan. I love their computers. I have, you know, more than one mouse that's from Razer. And personally, I really like the design of this mouse. It feels great in the hand, not super bulky like a lot of other mouses that are out there. It doesn't matter if you're a left hand or a right hand person, it works both ways, and you can switch the keys and the buttons to anything that you want. This mouse comes with the Ultimate Hyperspeed Technology wireless connection thing that I don't know what's the difference, but it's pretty much close to it being wired and it's wireless. So you can pretty much play games with this, and I've even tried playing games with this, and honestly, I've been more accurate as far as like shooting games and stuff like that. So it's making me a better gamer. But the reason that I feel like it's one of the best mouses for making music is because the programmable buttons. You know, there's other mouses out there that have programmable buttons and stuff like that, but they only come with 2 buttons that you can program, or maybe even less than 8. But this mouse comes with 8 programmable buttons. So let me show you. So here's Razer Synapse. You need this program to, you know, change the colors that are on the mouse. This mouse comes with RGB lighting, so you can make it fit your aesthetics and stuff like that. So as soon as you click on mouse, this pops up, and see right here, there are literally like a couple buttons on the side of the mouse that you can really program it to anything. So here I have it to being Control S. So whenever I'm making music, I can just hit this button real quick and then boom, it saves my session. Like, I don't know how many times I forget to save a session, and then I can easily do it without, you know, using two fingers on the keyboard and hitting one button on Control, one button on the S, you know, or just, you know, trying to do gang signs on the keyboard. It's just doing too much, you know what I'm saying? But I will say this, it's not a thing that you need to have to make music. It's just a luxury, you know what I'm saying? It's more like a luxury type thing, and I love it. I got one button set to Control S. I probably might change it to another button later. I got another button for B in my program. It changes my tools that I'm using, like a paintbrush tool. I got another button set right here in FL Studio. If you hit F6, that basically brings up either the pattern window or the mixer, and I can do it all from my mouse. So I can probably work and make beats a lot faster. So let's just try it out real quick. So if I hit my button for the save button, look at that. This is awesome. Next, if I hit one of the buttons for the mixer, look at that. I can just flip between mixers, pads, and all type of stuff, and you can program it to anything. Let me know in the comments what keyboard shortcuts that you guys use all the time that you could probably program in a mouse. You don't got to sit there and get on the keyboard and throw up gang signs. You can just hit a button and get that same effect. So to change this to the keyboard shortcut that you want, just click on the button that you want to do or change the effect to or whatever, and then hit keyboard function. And then as soon as you hit that button, you just put whatever keypad or whatever key shortcut that you're going to use, and then it'll save that. So let's do, for example, Control Z, you know what I'm saying? Boom, and then hit save. So that's pretty much undo. You guys know the shortcut for that. So if I hit that and then hit that button, boom, I just undid it. You know what I'm saying? So I feel like you can pretty much make beats a lot faster when you have a luxury type of mouse like this. Like I said, it's not necessary to use for making music, but it's a huge luxury to have. And why not just have it? It's under $100. It's not like you're spending $1,000 on a mouse. And you can program this thing to different programs. So say if you're in the web browser, you can set it up to different things per application. So I feel like this is very, very, very useful for music producers, music artists, people that just do a lot of stuff on different programs and stuff like that, and it can save you a lot of time. I also got this accessory, which is a mouse grip tape. If you ever felt like your mouse was just a little bit slippery, or sometimes you just lose a little bit of grip on your mouse when you're like making music for hours, you get a little sweaty. So this will pretty much help with that. I'm gonna pretty much put it in on the video. I'm gonna put this in, and honestly, it feels pretty great. I like the way how it feels. Even sometimes when I'm playing games, I feel a little bit more accurate because I have this tape on there. It just has a little bit more satisfying feel. Let me know right now in the comments, what mouse are you currently using for your music production, productivity, setup? Personally, I just think this is just the best mouse for making music. I really feel like you can use this for the hi-hats too as well. Say like you have a hi-hat right here and you want to quickly do some rows or something like that, you know, highlight it. Normally what you would do is Alt-A. You can quickly get some rows like that. But say I do that on the mouse, you know, I can just highlight that, right, and just click that button, and then boom, I have rows just ready to go. Like I said, you have 8 programmable buttons to any keyboard shortcut that you want to set it to. So just think about all the keyboard shortcuts that you have right now. You can program that into this mouse and then get that with the click of a button, which is why I feel like this is the best mouse for making music. It just has so many buttons to program, and it feels really great. It's very low profile. If you don't want any RGB lighting or anything like that, it pretty much looks like it's not there. It goes away, and there's no logos, there's no anything on it. And I pretty much like the little stealthy look that it has, but I like the lights on it, so I just keep that on. And you have so many effects that you could do. Razer has the best lighting as far as any other brand out there. And hey, if you're watching this video, Razer, go ahead and sponsor me, you know what I'm saying? It's your boy, you know what I mean? Yeah, hope you guys like this video. Let me know what other videos you would like to see on this channel. Hope you guys stay safe, and remember, it's only a matter of time. Peace.